Hey there everyone, Omega Snake here, and well, everyone has done one of these at one point or another, so I figured why not do the same myself. So basically I'm gonna be reacting to the newest Nintendo Direct. Now I didn't see it when it went live, but I managed to avoid all spoilers for it except for the fact that Star Fox was gonna be talked about during this Direct, but that's all I know about it. Now, basically, I'm just gonna basically be showing my reactions to it, like basically what I think about the things that come up and things like that. So yeah, that's basically what I'm gonna do right now. I'm just going to react to it because, I feel like I'm missing. I'm the only one that hasn't really done anything like that. So anyway, here we go. In a 3, 2, 1, here we go. I know Nintendo is gonna hit me with copyright for this, but honestly, I wasn't planning on making money on this video anyway, so.
Hi everyone, Bill Trinan here from Nintendo to deliver some new information about upcoming games. You
Hey,
may
Bill.
think you know all about our 2016 lineup, but we have a few secrets left to reveal about some games you may have heard of. We'll begin with Star Fox Zero, so let's kick it over to someone who knows all about shooting for the stars, Shigeru Miyamoto.
Oh, Star Fox is first? Okay, then.
Konnichiwa.
All right.
Hi everyone, I'm Shigeru Miyamoto, a game
Hello, Mr.
producer at
Miyamoto.
Nintendo. I'm here today in New York City. It's 3 degrees Fahrenheit outside, so it's very cold.
Yeah, it's not much warmer over here where I am either.
I'm so sorry for keeping you waiting. Star Fox Zero is finally ready.
Sweet.
We made this game to be an authentic action game, the kind I haven't worked on for a long time.
Yeah, no kidding.
It turned out to be the type of game where the more you practice, the more fun it gets.
Sweet.
The plot and the game structure are similar to the Star Fox on Nintendo 64, but the story and map structure here are completely new.
Sweet.
This time, there are teleporters that appear in the game. The teleporters play an important role in the storyline and also have a big impact on the branching paths in the map. Now, I'd like to talk about a stage that we haven't shown yet. This is Fortuna.
Fortuna.
It's packed with dangerous bioweapons and will prove pretty challenging, so enjoy going up against all new enemies. Some pretty giant ones, too.
Man, Fortuna used to be such a dump.
There are also a lot of alternate paths in the maps. You can see this looks like the Cornelia stage at first, but there is actually a branch in the path on the right. When you take this path, it leads to a new level. If you go through here, you'll be confronted by a never-before-seen boss. This boss is also worth defeating, and once you win, you'll be taken back to the map, where even more paths will open up.
Wow.
Just like that, Star Fox Zero is a game where once you defeat Venom in normal mode, many new and alternate paths will appear. As you explore these different paths, you'll encounter Starwolf and his four-man team. They'll provide a really tough challenge.
They always did before.
The player can use the new target mode and various maneuvers and other new attack strategies to battle Starwolf throughout the game.
Ooh, they have new attacks too?
Venom and Andross, but of course, the gameplay is completely new. On the way, you'll realize that there are multiple paths available for you to reach the final destination. Please try it out for yourselves to see how many paths there are.
Okay, now I'm hyped for this.
There's also a two-player mode. One player can fly the R-Wing, while the other player aims and shoots. You can play this way cooperating with your friends and aim for high scores, or you can get together with your family and just have fun clearing each level.
Wow, that's a great way to
now,
add
to
some
those who have the
co-op.
Smash Brothers Fox Amiibo, yes, you can use it. With it, you'll be able to play with the R-Wing from the classic Super NES game, and there might even be some other bonuses waiting for you. I hope you try
oh
it
Oh my
out.
God, the chip
One
looks
more
so
thing,
old!
I want to talk to you about a new game. Some
new
of you
game.
May remember that I showed a game 2 E3s ago that was called Project Guard.
Yeah.
This game is now complete and is called Star Fox Guard. Slippy's Uncle Grippy is busy with the job of gathering rare metals in space, but is under attack from all kinds of enemies. In this game, you use Slippy's newly invented security system to ward off these enemies. The player uses 12 cameras, setting them up in various locations to find and attack the enemies to protect the mining site.
It does
there
look
are
a lot
about
better.
100 missions to play, but that's not all. You can also edit the placement of enemies, and then you can upload these enemy patterns online so others can play them.
Ooh, like a level creator, but different.
You can play other players' creations, or have others play yours to earn precious medals. I hope you'll play Star Fox Guard with people from all around the world. Get good at changing those cameras. Speaking of changing cameras, let's switch it back over to Bill.
Wow.
Thanks, Mr. Miyamoto.
I am really hyped for Star Fox Zero.
Both games, Star Fox Zero and Star Fox Guard, will come packaged together as a set.
Nice.
Those who purchase the digital versions can buy them separately in Nintendo eShop, or buy both games for the same total price as the packaged bundle. Star Fox Zero and Star Fox Guard both launch on April 22nd, 2016.
That's next month.
It's about time you showed up, Fox.
Yeah,
you're the only
no
hope
kidding.
For our world. You know, there's another Wii U game that's received a number of updates, and I think its fans may want in on a little secret.
Hmm?
It ain't over yet for Splatoon.
Oh, really?
First,
I thought it was.
We'll be releasing an update that aims to balance some of the gear abilities and adjust various systems in the game, such as matchmaking. For gear, these changes will improve some of the lesser-used abilities to make them more appealing. Additionally, we'll be making some changes to matchmaking and team assignments for ranked battle and adding a couple of elements to the Splatfests to improve the overall user experience.
Hmm.
This first update will be released next week on March 8th. The second update we have planned will pertain mostly to weapons in the game. In addition to adjusting some already existing weapons, we'll be adding new weapon set recommendations. These combinations will feature a selection of some of the most popular and underappreciated weapons chosen by the owner of Ammo Knights himself, Sheldon.
Hmm.
We'll be dividing this update into two parts, and the first will be arriving in April.
Okay.
We'll also be releasing information about these updates on our website and via our official channels, so make sure to check it out.
Hmm.
Next,
okay.
A Wii U game you're all expecting that comes with some unexpected twists.
Oh, really?
Here's part of the opening movie in Mario and Sonic at the Rio 2016 Olympic Games.
Ah, the Olympic Games. You know, I feel like I'm one of the only ones that actually like these games. They're fun. They're actually pretty fun. I like playing them with my family, too. Oh, Rosalina's joining. And it looks like some of the Sinister Six is going to be. Or was it the Deadly Six? I can't remember. Football, huh? Boxing. Sweet. Nice to see more characters, honestly. Is that a parade? Huh. Volleyball. Soccer. Mario and Sonic at the Rio 2016 Olympic Games.
A new event is making its debut in the Rio 2016 Olympic Games, Rugby Sevens, and it's a lot of fun. It's also a series first, as is Rhythmic Gymnastics Clubs. Not to mention, every Olympic Games event in the game takes place in venues modeled after the actual venues in Rio.
Wow.
Mario and Sonic at the Rio 2016 Olympic Games launches on Wii U June 24th. We'll keep you updated on the other events and more game details down the line. We'll get back to more Wii U games in just a sec.
I like Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games.
Remember that you'll first get a chance to earn your place on the podium beside two gaming powerhouses when Mario and Sonic at the Rio 2016 Olympic Games launches on the Nintendo 3DS system March 18th.
Hmm.
Next, let's see what's new in Super Mario Maker. It's been about 6 months since the game arrived on Wii U, and players around the world continue to upload exciting new courses every day.
Oh yeah,
in fact,
no kidding.
There are more than 6.2 million courses for players to jump into at this very moment. Since launch, we've added new course elements on two separate occasions. And here we go again.
Uh-oh.
It's update time. Now, when you shake a Thwomp, it'll transform into a skewer from Super Mario World.
Ooh.
Thwomps were already pretty beefy, but these are an even bigger pain, in a good way.
Oh,
also,
boy.
When you shake a P-switch, it'll turn into a key. Plus, shaking a door will now make it a key door. Yep, you guessed it. Can't open one of those without a key.
Oh, sweet, I was hoping for one of those.
Make an enemy hold one, and you can make levels where you can't advance without a key. Which means
sweet
you can now make
rush.
Courses with mandatory boss battles. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
And if you shake
I've been
a coin,
wanting to do something
it'll
like
change
that.
Into a pink coin. Collect them all, and a key will appear. That way, you can make an adventurous level where you have to find all the pink coins to win. These
oh, I'm getting some ideas already.
Expand your puzzle-making horizons. We're also adding new elements to online play. The update will let you play 100 Mario Challenge on a new Super Expert mode. It'll unlock after clearing Expert mode, and it'll dish out a volley of 6 extremely tough levels for you to beat with 100 Marios. Your prize for winning? New Mystery Mushroom costumes. So even if you think you have them all, give this new mode a try and see if you can get them all.
Tetra,
additionally,
huh?
The Super Mario Maker bookmark site will see additions such as ranking categories for world records and the number of first clears on courses, inspiring new ways to create and play in the main game. This new update will be available for download on March 9th.
Sweet, that's not too far. That's like
sometimes
next week.
One of the best parts of an RPG is its style, and no one understands that quite like Atlus, the makers of this next Wii U game. Tokyo Mirage Sessions Sharp FE is a brand new IP that takes inspiration from Atlus' own titles and the Fire Emblem series.
Oh yes, I've been waiting for this one.
It's an energetic fusion of the deep RPG gameplay you'd expect from an Atlus game and the adrenaline-fueled fun of a huge pop idol concert. Every inch oozes style, from the in-game music videos and commercials to the hot new tracks from AVEX, the company behind some of the biggest pop stars in Japan. And speaking of, the game is based in Japan, so we're keeping its original VO track and adding in English subtitles.
Nice. Aww, I was hoping for dubs.
If you consider yourself a JRPG fan or just someone daring enough to try something new, look no further. Your summer is now complete. Tokyo Mirage Sessions Sharp FE will arrive stateside June 24th.
Nice. I will
you
still play the game, but I'm bummed that there's no
Nintendo
dubs. I prefer dubs over subs.
Lost Reavers is Bandai Namco's latest free-to-play online co-op action game. Team up
Lost
with other
Reavers,
adventurers
huh?
online to fight zombies and solve puzzles as you search for valuable treasure in the most diverse locations on the planet. You'll need the wits to solve puzzles, the expertise to kill bosses, and the firepower to fight legions of undead guardians.
This
acquire
does look
treasure
fun.
And successfully make your way back to complete the mission and receive your share of the spoils. As you go on missions, characters will level up, unlock more skills, and increase their funds so you can acquire new weapons.
Nice.
Each map also has a variety of different routes, puzzles, and enemy spawns, so levels can be played and enjoyed multiple times. You can look forward to playing Lost Reavers in the open beta version coming soon to Wii U.
Open beta, huh?
Next, let's paint the town red, and just about every other color. In the Paper Mario series, we always challenge ourselves to bring something fresh to the action-adventure genre. And this time, in Paper Mario Color Splash, the theme is colors and paint. As such, the game takes place in a colorful paradise called Prism Island.
I hope it's a little better than Sticker Star.
Something is very wrong.
What's
Prism
that?
Island is being drained of its color. To make sense of all this, it's up to Paper Mario to do like he does and set off on a journey to bring color back to the land. And his new paint hammer is just the ticket. It splashes paint on anything he hits, restoring the island's color bit by bit.
Nice.
He can even splash paint on colorless toads to revive the poor little guys. A splash of color will even liven up a toad house. In battle, you'll paint cards like this and then flick them to start the battle. There are special cards, too. They'll unleash some satisfyingly powerful attacks. The latest entry in this beloved series, Paper Mario Color Splash, is currently planned for release in 2016.
Okay, I hope it will be a little better than
Machamp,
Sticker Star.
Gengar,
it wasn't
and many
too bad,
more
but
of your favorite Pokemon
a lot
are about to face off in Pokken Tournament for Wii U.
Yes, Pokken Tournament!
In the Faerun League, players will start at the bottom tier, facing off against relatively easy opponents. But as you move up in the ranks, you'll encounter skilled opponents worthy of your absolute best.
Oh yeah.
Winning a fight in any mode earns in-game currency that allows you to change the appearance of your avatar.
Oh, cool.
Battles will require quick reflexes and the ability to read your opponent. Some Pokemon are fast and can use their speed to rush in and deal damage. Other Pokemon rely on their brute power to dominate the competition. Each main battle Pokemon and pairings of support Pokemon can change the way you approach the fight.
Wow.
So find your favorite combination to suit your playstyle. To help you determine which Pokemon you should try first, here's a few highlights of main battle Pokemon. Lucario uses powerful aura-based attacks to create attacking projectiles from far away. After activating burst attack mode, Lucario can unleash a massive beam of aura energy to get back into the battle or to finish it off.
Ouch!
Machamp capitalizes on brute strength via rapid-fire punches, damaging throws, and more to send opponents reeling. This
Ouch.
Pokemon is a real heavy hitter and a force to be reckoned with when up close and personal.
Well, at least he's not as bad as Goro.
Last but not least, Gengar pulls out every trick in the book to keep opponents guessing. If instantly appearing anywhere, throwing punches from out of nowhere, and more doesn't scare you, then Gengar's final burst attack move is really the stuff of nightmares.
Yo!
Adopters, an exclusive amiibo card of Shadow Mewtwo will come within the physical copy of the first production run of the game.
Sweet.
So make sure you grab it early, as it won't last forever. Pokken Tournament launches on Wii U March 18th.
Whoa, that's really soon.
Day, make sure to catch the final battles of the Pokken Tournament Early Access Competition that airs on March 17th. And tomorrow, March 4th, we'll return to the land of Hyrule, or journey for the first time, to experience an updated version of one of the most stirring tales in the Zelda series. The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess HD. Visit our YouTube channel to watch the Twilight Princess retrospective video series and learn all about the making of the original from development team members. The fourth and final episode will fill you in on all the new features in the Wii U version when it launches tomorrow alongside the game. March is also a big month for Nintendo 3DS, but no matter your system of choice, Nintendo has your back. Because this month also sees the introduction of Nintendo's new loyalty program.
Oh, really?
My Nintendo. It's more than just a traditional point program. My Nintendo aims to offer more comprehensive and integrated features that will reward you for interacting with Nintendo products and services in a variety of new ways.
Hmm.
You can pre-register for Nintendo's first smart device app, Mitomo, and sign up for a Nintendo account now to become a My Nintendo member and start earning My Nintendo Platinum points. Stay tuned for more details to come.
Okay.
You know, there's another thing you can
do. I still do miss Club Nintendo,
though. And it involves Amiibo. Mini Mario and Friends Amiibo Challenge is a special treat for all you Amiibo lovers out there. In this free download for Wii U and Nintendo 3DS, you can tap compatible Amiibo figures to guide one of 10 mini characters through specific levels that they alone can access. Each mini has their own powers, too, like Mini Mario, who can wall jump. There are some other really neat powers as well. This game will be available for early access at participating retailers beginning March 25th with the purchase of any Nintendo Amiibo figure. It will also be available to download for free from Nintendo eShop on Wii U and Nintendo 3DS beginning April 28th. In other Amiibo news, Series 4 of the Animal Crossing Amiibo cards are on the way this June.
Nice.
Also keep an eye out for
Isabel looks so
Amiibo
cute.
Which will be available individually, separate from the Animal Crossing Amiibo Festival bundle in June as well. And she'll be accompanied by another Amiibo figure, this time sporting her summer outfit. Now let's take a look at what else is new in Nintendo eShop for Nintendo 3DS. Virtual Console is about to receive an upgrade, exclusively on new Nintendo 3DS systems. We'll begin releasing Super NES Virtual Console titles, complete with new Nintendo 3DS exclusive features, like Perfect Pixel Mode, which displays each game in its original resolution. The classic games you see on screen and more are coming in the near future. The very near future. To begin, these original Super NES launch games will be available in Nintendo eShop for new Nintendo 3DS systems following today's presentation.
Oh, wow.
We'll add to the lineup with these titles on March 24th, and then even more on April 14th. The legendary games of the Super NES era hold a special place in many gamers' hearts.
You're not kidding.
So I'm planning to turn my new Nintendo 3DS XL into my own portable Super NES vault. I hope you do too.
I don't have a new Nintendo 3DS yet.
And horse racing
though I should get
it
soon.
Because they're not. But that didn't stop the developers at Game Freak. In Pocket Card Jockey, you'll play as a jockey who has to partake in a fast-paced, simplified version of Solitaire to propel your horse through intense races.
Okay.
As you clear cards, you'll earn Unity Power, which is used to move your horse on the track or saved for a boost in the home stretch. It's all about leveling up your horse through strategic positioning and placement on the track. As the level rises, your horse's stats will increase, and you'll gain bonuses too. Over time, you'll start to win trophies for high-ranking races, which will draw in sponsors. And eventually, you'll retire your faithful steed, and then another, and pair them up on the farm to breed and train new ponies. Before you know it, you may be surprised at just how deep such a simple game could be. Find out for yourself when Pocket Card Jockey rides into Nintendo eShop for Nintendo 3DS in May.
It looks
cute.
Next up, I don't know if
I'll
get it,
Striker Gunvolt 2.
Ooh,
the first game
two.
In the series featured the exciting, fast-paced 2D action that you've come to expect from Inti Creates. For the sequel, the action has evolved and comes equipped with new features. Now, Gunvolt's rival Culpin has joined the fray as a playable character. Dash into enemies to lock onto them, then
I've never played the original Gunvolt, so...
But that's not all. Culpin can also copy the abilities of all seven new boss characters and use them as his own. If you haven't had a chance to play the original yet, from March 2nd till June 1st, Azure Striker Gunvolt will be available at a discounted price in Nintendo eShop.
Ooh.
Azure Striker Gunvolt
maybe I should
will
get
be
it.
Available in Nintendo eShop on 3DS this summer. Last month, Fire Emblem Fates marched on to Nintendo 3DS systems. And this month,
yeah, a lot of my friends are raving about it.
The game will become available, along with the next installment in a series of downloadable content. This third path through the story, Fire Emblem Fates Revelation, will do as its name implies and reveal many secrets you can't discover in the paths of Birthright or Conquest. When the Revelation path releases on March 10th, select Explore Fates in the title screen to connect to the internet and purchase Revelation in-game for just under 20 real-world dollars. Once you purchase the path, a third option will appear at the Branch of Fate in Chapter 6. Refuse to choose a side. And today, two new maps will be released at the in-game DLC shop, Dragon's Gate. You can acquire rare weapons on the map Museum Melee. And on March 17th, the map Royal Royale will be released.
Royal Royale.
In this map, the siblings of both kingdoms will have to spar to determine who among them is worthy of the task to save an alternate version of Korin from another world. Each map is available at Dragon's Gate for the price you see on screen. But if you've purchased Map Pack 1, they're already yours for the taking.
Oh, wow.
And keep an eye out for even more DLC maps added weekly.
I really need
to
get into Fire
21st.
Emblem, but
March
I just haven't been able to.
Friends, the battle isn't over yet. 3 weeks from today, Hyrule Warriors Legends will declare war on Nintendo 3DS systems. As fans of the
right.
Wii U version already know, the game will pit you as one of your favorite Zelda characters against a near limitless army of Moblins, Dodongos, and the like. You can even battle as characters from The Legend of Zelda, The Wind Waker, and the brand new character, Linkle. Fans of the Wii U version were dedicated to finishing the fight and enjoyed the amount of additional content that was offered. And so,
oh, yeah.
I'm pleased to announce that Hyrule Warriors Legends will also have some new downloadable content available in 2016. Beginning on launch day, you can buy a season pass, which will give you access to four brand new DLC packs.
Okay.
If you buy the season pass, you'll get an exclusive bonus costume for Ganondorf, available on launch day only.
Oh, his Wind Waker costume!
These
Sweet!
Packs will also be available for purchase individually. On launch day, Anyone in the U.S. who picks up a physical copy of Hyrule Warriors Legends will receive a download code for a free Nintendo 3DS Hyrule Warriors Legends theme. And a transfer code will allow purchasers who own the Wii U version of the game to download and play as the five new characters and use Ganondorf's trident weapon from Hyrule Warriors Legends in the original Hyrule Warriors on Wii U.
Nice.
Finally, if you pre-order the game at GameStop in the U.S., you'll also receive a special edition, softcover, 16-page character art book. With it, you can learn more about key characters and view concept art of various warriors and weapons, including the new hero Linkle and her mysterious compass. There's another new character flying our way, and she'll be available to download for free in both Hyrule Warriors Legends and Hyrule Warriors on Wii U.
A new character?
Medley is her
Medley!
Name.
Medley!
The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker was her first game. Now, she and her harp are ready for battle. You can add Medley to your roster as a free download, launching alongside the release of the first DLC pack.
Oh, I love Medley!
Charge into battle when Hyrule Warriors
cute.
Legends releases on Nintendo 3DS March 25th. Next, let's brush up on our art skills with true masters of the craft. Disney Art Academy is a fun game that'll teach you how to draw popular Disney and Pixar characters.
I'm not really
Lessons
much of an art student.
Lessons feature a wide range of characters, and your instructor will teach you how to draw them step by step. Draw lines, color them in, add shadows and highlights as you're instructed, and voila! Anyone can create beautiful illustrations of Disney and Pixar characters like these. With a wave of the magic brush, you can give your masterpiece a touch of stars, glitter, clouds, and more. Sample artwork will include a variety of characters, from Mickey Mouse and Winnie the Pooh, to beloved Disney princesses, to some of Pixar's best, and yes, even Disney's Frozen. Plus, you'll learn a variety of art styles depending on the illustrations you're drawing.
I'm sorry, but
skills and have
like,
some fun when Disney Art Academy launches on Nintendo 3DS.
I guess if you're really trying to learn
the
some
original
how
Bravely
to draw,
Default
then,
gave
you know,
thousands
this is good.
Of RPG fans exactly what they were looking for, and a big part of that was the exciting jobs your characters could take on to learn powerful abilities. Across the world, you'll encounter dozens of jobs that each bring different strengths to the table. As for today, I thought I'd spotlight a couple of the jobs that are new to the sequel. Bravely Second End Lair, which is fast approaching.
I never
Some
played
jobs
the
may
Bravely,
sound like standard
Bravely
RPG fare, but I assure
default.
You the wizard is anything but. Wizards use spellcraft to customize spells with added effects, like hammer and mist. For a powerful strategy, try combining this with the elemental spells of black and red mages, or the healing spells of white mages. And then there's the Catmancer. They learn the moves of the monsters you encounter, and then train cats to perform them in exchange for treats. One way to test out some of the new jobs is with the upcoming Bravely Second demo. The demo's story revolves around the Three Cavaliers, an elite band of Crystal Guard knights that Her Holiness, Agnes Oblige, has dispatched to look into disturbances that have been cropping up. This side story can only be experienced in this free demo when it launches in Nintendo eShop March 10th.
Huh.
Best Buy Gamers Club Unlocked members will also receive a unique 16-digit code to access the demo early on March 7th. Playing the demo will net you play bonuses you can transfer into the full version of the game when it becomes available for purchase.
Hmm.
And if you're so inclined, you can pre-purchase the game for Nintendo 3DS also on March 10th in the Nintendo eShop. And right now, there's another great way to get a taste for this series. The free demo for the original Bravely Default is still available in Nintendo eShop. When you're ready to jump into the sequel, there's also a collector's edition of Bravely Second End Lair that will include the game, a soundtrack CD, and this.
What's that?
The official art book. It'll give you a bigger, better look at the series' memorable characters, landscapes, monsters, and much, much more.
Mm.
If you want to learn about this new entry in the franchise, stay tuned to our YouTube channel this month for our new Bravely Second End Lair video series. Bravely Second End Lair launches exclusively on Nintendo 3DS systems April 15th.
Wow,
another massive RPG is headed to Nintendo 3DS, and it's one fans have been clamoring for. Dragon Quest VII, Fragments of the Forgotten Past, has been completely remade for Nintendo 3DS. It's essentially a brand new game. The world has been rebuilt, The characters have new 3D models, and the story has been completely retranslated. You play as Oster, the young son of a famous fisherman.
I haven't played any of the Dragon Quest games, but...
And trust me, he's gonna get it. He sets off on an adventure with the mischievous Prince Kiefer.
I feel like I'm missing out on
something. Headstrong girl named Maribel.
Maybe I'll try a Dragon Quest game at some point.
The trio search the world for fragments of stone tablets. After putting the tablets together again, they warp to the past in order to save the present. Along the way, they'll engage in classic turn-based combat and gain access to more than 30 classes with powerful abilities. With art by Akira Toriyama and the pedigree of the Dragon Quest series, this is pure RPG goodness. Dragon Quest VII, Fragments of the Forgotten Past, launches on Nintendo 3DS later this year. In Japan, there's a game known as Monster Hunter Cross, the latest game in the Monster Hunter series. And now it's coming west as Monster Hunter Generations.
Ooh.
With the new style system and hunter arts, this is the most customizable Monster Hunter experience ever. And you can get a taste of what's to come in this debut trailer.
Let's look. I love Monster Hunter. Four colossal threats at the surface. Oh boy. That is a woolly mammoth! Acquire powerful new abilities. The Rathian. Prepare for the hunt. Monster Hunter Generations. Summer 2016. Ooh, that's pretty
close. We'll have more to say about the game in the future, but for now, a quick shout out. Anyone who plays Monster Hunter Generations on a Nintendo 3DS with Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate save data present on it will receive bonus content in the new game.
Nice!
As a special promotion, Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate is being offered at a special price of $19.99 in Nintendo eShop for 48 hours, starting today at 3 p.m. Pacific Time.
That's pretty cheap.
It's a great game and a great reason to get hyped for the next one. Here's another. I'm happy to announce that Monster Hunter Generations will feature a special collaboration armor set based on Marth from the Fire Emblem series.
Nice!
To see the full-length trailer of this collaboration, head over to twitter.com/monsterhunter.
I'm going to have to do that after this.
Monster Hunter Generations will be available on Nintendo 3DS in summer 2016.
Marth.
At E3, there was one game we introduced that left fans with some questions. Today, Kensuke Tanabe, the producer of the Metroid Prime series, is here to help you understand how
questions,
Metroid Prime Federation
more like
Force
anger.
Will become an integral part of the Metroid Prime universe. Tanabe-san?
Hello, everyone. I'm Kensuke Tanabe. I started from the GameCube version, so it's been about 15 years since I first became the producer of the Metroid Prime series. Today, I want to introduce you to the newest installment in the Metroid Prime series, Metroid Prime Federation Force. Being a new title in a series we deeply love, as a development team, we approach it with great passion and effort. Development on this game started in 2009.
Oh, wow.
At that time, we started with the idea of developing a new online multiplayer-focused Metroid Prime title for a handheld system. Early experiments began in collaboration with our reliable partners at Next Level Games, who I had worked with on Mario Strikers for GameCube and on Punch-Out for Wii. We kicked off official development with them, but at that point, we were working on the Nintendo DSi. And with the DSi, it became clear that we wouldn't be able to achieve the type of performance fans would expect. When we saw the new Nintendo 3DS a few years later, for one thing, we knew that the Nintendo 3DS would address our performance issues, and we were also excited about the expanded control options provided by the C-Stick. At that point, we decided to restart the project.
Ah, okay.
We wanted to use this new game to tell the story of the battle between the Galactic Federation and the Space Pirates. I had always imagined battles between these two within the universe, but we had never really explored that in the previous games. I'd been wanting to do it for over 10 years, so I was ready and excited to try.
Hey,
but
I don't blame
given
you.
The focus on the Galactic Federation and Space Pirate battle, while Samus would appear in the story, it meant that she couldn't be the main player character this time. So, using the Galactic Federation soldiers as the main characters was the natural course of action for this game. Another theme we wanted to add to the game system was the idea, like an RPG, of players having the ability to choose their own distinct roles in the game, like a healer, a warrior, a mage, and so on. You receive certain types of sub-weapons from the Federation in each mission, and players must divide them among themselves based on a weight limit before taking them on a mission.
Ah, okay.
So, for example, if you carry a lot of repair capsules, then that player becomes a sort of healer in the game. And if you take on all the missiles, then you become a warrior. I would love to explain more about that aspect today, about the character's art style, or why we created Blast Ball, and so on. But let's save that for another time.
All
what
right.
I can say for sure is that Metroid Prime Federation Force is a game that absolutely belongs in the Metroid universe. That
it does
I
look
promise.
Like it.
Please
I'm actually a little excited for it because, you know, it's like
Samus Aran's solitary war on the Space Pirates terminated their Phazon experiments on Metroids. But the galaxy is not at peace. Recognizing a need to combat the Space Pirate menace, the Galactic Federation launched Project Golem, a top-secret program to develop mechanized battle armor based on the technology in Samus Aran's power suit. The most elite members of the Galactic Marines were chosen and put through intense training to form what would become the Federation Force.
Okay.
Their first mission is to survey the three-planet Bermuda system and reclaim an abandoned Federation outpost on the resource-rich planet Excelsion, which was devastated by a meteor crash 20 years ago, plunging it into an ice age.
Yeah, looks like it. So that explains why those guys look like that. They're giant power suits.
On Excelsion, all that stood in the way were mere ice hoppers. But then the team came face to face with a well-known threat they weren't expecting.
Space pirates.
Now the only way to survive is to work as a team, to master their mechs, and to take down the Space Pirates against all odds.
It honestly does look like a good game.
Isn't over yet.
Metroid Prime Federation Force. It honestly does look like a good game. I think
stay tuned for
the
more
backlash just came from the timing
next chapter
of it. That's
in the Metroid
all.
Prime universe. We'll also be hosting several hands-on opportunities, starting with WonderCon in late March. So I hope you'll try the game out for yourself. Metroid Prime Federation Force releases on Nintendo 3DS systems late spring 2016.
That's not too far.
Next, I'd like to announce a game that combines some great selections from some great games. Rhythm Heaven on Nintendo DS.
Ooh.
Rhythm Heaven Fever on Wii, and more. Introducing Rhythm Heaven Megamix, which will be coming to North America this year. Rhythm Heaven Megamix on Nintendo 3DS offers more than 100 rhythm games, 70 of which have been carefully selected from previous titles in the series, including the original Game Boy Advance game, which was never released in North America. There are also 30 brand new rhythm games, so replay a classic or tap into a new one when Rhythm Heaven Megamix launches later this year. Now, let's take a look
never played
at
any
one
of the rhythm
last
heaven.
Game. It has a lot of my coworkers tickled pink. Kirby's headed back to the Nintendo 3DS family of systems.
Ooh, Kirby!
This time, invaders have mechanized Dreamland.
Ooh.
To restore his home to its original form, Kirby must rise up. At first, the game may look familiar. The pink puff will travel through stages by jumping back and forth between the foreground and background while using more than 25 copy abilities. Of course, there will be new copy abilities.
Doctor!
But here's the kicker. In this game, Kirby will use his new enemy's tech against them.
Oh, really?
His Robobot armor is extremely strong, to the point where it can actually destroy obstacles that stand in Kirby's way. And taking a page from Kirby himself, the Robobot armor can copy enemy abilities and use powerful modified versions of them.
Wow!
The Robobot armor can use more than 10 modes. No matter what, Kirby and his Robobot armor will deliver two types of action for twice the fun. There's also a separate mode included in this game called Team Kirby Dash. It lets up to four players join forces to battle against powerful bosses. You'll select one of four roles and participate in a co-op quest to defeat a boss. Supporting your team by utilizing each role's abilities is the key to victory. While you play, you'll find tablets, and if you collect them all, your team can activate a powerful team meteor to inflict major damage.
Wow!
For the first time in a Kirby game, when you complete a quest, you'll gain experience points, and as you level up, your abilities will grow more powerful. That way, you can take on more difficult quests. Team Kirby Clash is available for download play as well, so you can play with friends who don't have the game yet, or you can play alone with sidekicks. In addition, this title is compatible with Amiibo. Tap them to give Kirby copy abilities in the game.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Some Amiibo will even give you character-specific abilities. For instance, tapping the Mario Amiibo will give you the fire ability. And tapping the Link Amiibo will give you the sword ability.
Of course.
In fact, if you tap any Amiibo, something is sure to happen, so try it out sometime. Alongside Kirby Planet Robobot on June 10th, we're launching a new line of Kirby series amiibo, including Kirby, of course, Meta Knight, King DDD, and the irreplaceable Waddle Dee. When you tap any of these Kirby series amiibo, Kirby will receive a copy ability, but he'll also get a costume unique to each figure.
Nice.
Not to mention, the Kirby figure grants him a power you can only get in this game with amiibo, the UFO ability. Who knew Kirby was such a tech guru? Kirby Planet Robobot will mechanize your gaming world on June 10th.
That actually looks
Thanks
like a great Kirby
game. Thanks
for tuning
in to this Nintendo Direct. When we have more to reveal, we'll let you know. See you next time.
Okay, so, wow. A lot of games there. So, yeah, I'm actually a little more hyped for some of the games. Some of the games I couldn't really care less about, but overall, this was a great Direct. I'm really excited for Monster Hunter and Star Fox and a couple of others, but overall, yeah, looks like Nintendo is basically busting out a lot of their guns. And, oh yeah, before I go, I do want to say, I do think Federation Force is a bit overhated. I mean, seriously, the game hasn't even come out yet. And I'm actually glad that they actually addressed this, because, well, it looks like that they were actually planning this for a long time, but they couldn't get it off the ground, so it kind of went on the back burner. But now I see that, you know, now that they saw that the 3DS could handle what they were asking, they were like, you know what, let's start this up. Yeah, overall, it's like Federation Force looks like it's going to be a good game. It's just the timing of it. Because Metroid's 30th was coming out and it was coming up and everything. So, you know, people thought, is this a celebration of Samus's 30th? I don't know, but it's like, apparently it wasn't. It was just something that they had on the back burner for a while. So, yeah, I have a feeling that if they announced this like the E3 before, then people would not have been nearly as bad about it, you know? I just feel like, you know what, guys? Wait till the game comes out and then say if it's just a really bad game, 'cause honestly, I am a little interested in this. Yeah, you can't play as Samus, but I do actually want to know a little bit more of the lore of Metroid, so... You know, I might get this. I might get that one. Who knows? Anyway, guys, I hope you guys enjoy my reactions, and I hope that you guys are also hyped for what Nintendo has brought up. I just hope that you guys enjoyed this. I'm gonna get back into a few of my other videos, and oh yeah, also my Five Nights at Freddy's will be starting this Monday. I'm sorry I didn't start it sooner. Things came up, and also Mother Nature just decided to be a bitch. You know how it is. Anyway, but yeah, Five Nights at Freddy's will be starting this Monday, and I hope you guys will be enjoying that. But until then, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Remember that if you want to help me out, I have a Patreon in the description below, and you guys can follow me on Facebook. But anyway, thanks for watching, guys. This is Omega Snake signing out, and I'll see you guys next time.